Hello everyone, welcome to MATLAB tutorial brought to you by MATLAB helper. In this video tutorial, we'll see Tridiagonal Systems in MATLAB. Certain matrices have a particular structure that can be exploited to develop efficient solution schemes. For example, a banded matrix is a square matrix that has all elements equal to 0 with the exception of a band centered on the main diagonal. A tridiagonal system has a bandwidth of 3 and can be expressed generally as this equation, where f are the diagonal components, e are the subdiagonal vectors or components, and g are the superdiagonal components. R in this equation are known as right hand side vectors. Consider a problem, solve the following tridiagonal system. So this is the given equation. Theoretically, the first step involves transforming the matrix to upper triangular form. This is done by multiplying the first equation by the factor E2 by F1 and subtracting the result from the second equation. It is as shown in this equation. We find the value of F2 and R2. In the next step, we use back substitution to generate the final solution, in which x4 is r4 by f4, and then we find x3, x2 and x1 using a standard formula rn minus gn x of n plus 1 by f of n. So we get the final solution. Now let us write a code. We write a function x equals to tridag e, f, g, r, where the inputs e are the subdiagonal vectors, f is the diagonal vector, g is the superdiagonal vector, and r is the right hand side vector. The output is stored in x, which is a solution vector. We define n as length of f, which is our diagonal vector, which is also the dimension of matrix. Next, we apply forward elimination. As we see in the theoretical part, in forward elimination, use the factor E of k by F of k minus 1. So we define that and find the value for F of k and R of k, where the value of k is from 2 to n. N is the length of diagonal vector. Next, for back substitution, we know xn equals to rn by fn, and then we implement a for loop to find x3, x2 and x1. To display the value of xn, we implement another for loop with I from 1 to length of x, and we use fprint to print the values. Now let us get the results. In the command window, we first define E, F, G and R from the given problem. So E from the given problem is 0, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. F is 2.04, 2.04, 2.04 and 2.04, which are the diagonal components. Similarly, we define G and R. Now we call tridiagonal function tridiag E, F, G, R. And here are the results. X1 equals to 65.96, X2 equals to 93, X3 equals to 124.53 and X4 equals to 159.47. We compare these results with the theoretical values and we see that both the results to be same. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit the like button. Also subscribe to our channel for updates on more such videos. Thank you. Bye-bye.